The educators in the inner city, Coach Starnett, and Andy Press, starts right now.
Today, we're going to talk about something that I've discovered today, which was, I'm just going to hop right into this. So, I have a student that's in my class that is out of control, that is disrespectful, does not pay attention, has already, like this is like the third week of school already, written up already. And, you know, tomorrow, well, next week, well, when this episode comes out, it'll be already next week. So I'll already have this conversation. But next week, I'm going to have my first ever parent-teacher conference with all the other teachers because we're trying to figure out what is going on. Like, we're trying to figure out what's going on.
Well,
and it's the third week of school. He's already disrespecting teachers. He's already not paying attention. And the thing is, I think almost every teacher has talked to him outside of class. Well, except for me. Well, actually, yes, I have. I think almost every teacher has talked to him outside of class. Because we're trying to figure out, basically, we're trying to figure out his story, basically. And what we can do to fix that.
Yo, that Nipsey always be saying some deep stuff. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, you listen to Nip, Nip gonna tell you some deep stuff over here, so, you know. But, so, here's my input. Let's cut the dramatics, you know, like, so there's something going on, mm-hmm. right? We don't know what's going on, right? But you're a sub. So I'm not even going to exclude you in this one, but I'm going to exclude, I'm going to put the other teams in there because if this child is going through what they're going through, then y'all know something is going on. Y'all been knew something was going on because he's not just acting out just to act out. All right. We not finna sit up here and play this whole little well, you know, if we do it like this, then we can do it like that. No, y'all already knew something was wrong with him. All right. Because when a child acts out, that means they're looking for attention. All right. I don't care what other people might say. I don't care what the expert's gonna say when they look at this. That child needs attention, but he's wanting to get attention in the wrong way. All right. So now we got to have a parent teacher conference, which I'm pretty sure they probably had more parent teacher conference with this young man before you even got there. Let's just be honest. So now we're going to play this game about we don't know what to do. And we got to see what it is that can get him engaged and keep him on the right path. Mm-hmm. Wish you could have grew up in my era. Because you wouldn't need to have no parent and teacher conference. I would put my foot off of your behind. Because at the end of the day, what I'm not going to do is go back and forth with you. What you're not going to do is to think you're going to just outright disrespect me and you think that that's cool. Mm-hmm. See, one thing about two things for sure, I appreciate how you handled this situation. It makes you mad, but you're professional. See, one thing about it, the respectful child wants you to go back and forth with them, right? Mm-hmm. Sit down, Ryan. Ryan, I done told you more than one time. All right, Ryan, look, you got one more. Now we losing teaching time because mm-hmm. I got to talk back and forth with you.
Mm-hmm.
Now, nothing to do that. Whatever that child is going through, they're going to have to fix that. Because whatever that child is going through, they bringing it to the school. All right, and you got to think about this. You just got over a pandemic.
Mm-hmm.
Them kids weren't really doing nothing anyway. You couldn't fail them. All right. So at the end of the day, I'm going to act how I act during the pandemic. I'm going to bring it back into this school year, and you ain't going to tell me nothing. I don't care if you're my sub, you're my regular teacher. I'm going to do what I do. But whatever I always said, bro, any conversation we've had, what do I always tell y'all? When a kid acts out, they're asking for help.
Yeah, they're asking for help.
But you don't have to be disrespectful in my classroom. But if that's the only way that you got to get my attention, then all right. But on a consistent basis,
right.
On a consistent basis, I know something wrong. Because you stay acting out. So it's really good. What is it that you're really not telling me? And then you say you talk to the teachers. It kind of makes me mad because why are we bringing in a sub when I've already dealt with the child? Why y'all ain't been putting no plan together for him?
Mm-hmm.
So now why they got to drag? I ain't going to say drag you in the mix, but now you got to come into this cake. You understand what I'm saying? You got to be mixed into the cake. You got to be baked in the oven. Just so we can bring it out and everything can be solidified and taste on a good level. Because when you have cake, it needs to be moist. Right. You understand what I'm saying? Because it gets that's how that flavor evaporates in your mouth. That's what we're dealing with here. We're dealing with a child who needs to be evaporated. But at the end of the day, y'all knew what this kid was bringing to the table.
Mm-hmm. All right.
And then what you going to tell them at the parent-teacher conference? The same thing that you probably told them last year? And how old is this young man?
11 or 12.
11 or 12.
So sixth grade? Yep, sixth grade.
That's trauma. That's trauma age. Come on now. We done had a conversation about that. That child going through something. That's around that trauma age. I mean, you have trauma when you're a small, like 6 or 7, but it ain't as deep as it is as they get older.
Mm-hmm.
So what is this child really going? Let me ask you this. Does he keep himself up? And what I mean by that, good clothes, haircut.
Yeah.
Okay.
Dress clean.
Mm-hmm.
Nice shoes, nice pants and everything. Nice haircut too.
So let me ask you this question. Does he pick on other people?
From time to time, he does go back and forth on one student.
Mm-hmm.
On occasion.
Mm-hmm.
From time to time.
Now this other student, dress clean.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so it ain't about what you got on. It ain't about what your family can afford. You just want to go back and forth.
Pretty much.
Is he a weakest link in your classroom? That kid that he goes back and forth with, is he a weak link?
As of today, yes. Because he has not turned in any assignments as of yet.
The one that's causing the issue?
Mm-hmm.
No, I'm not. When I say the weakest link, I'm talking about the guy that he goes back and forth with. Is he a weak link? Like,
is she the weakest link? No.
She.
Mm-hmm.
Do you say she?
She.
See, now we got an issue. Now we got an issue. Because I don't really think this young man realized how parents are today. See, I can go back and forth with a boy. But going back and forth with a girl? So you getting that from somewhere. So you done learned that. And if you learn that at home, I mean, your situation is a little more deeper than what we think. Yesterday, talked to my mom, right? The child, fourth grade, hit a girl. Yeah, you know, daddy's don't play about hitting a girl.
Yeah, it's done deal.
Police was involved. You're in the fourth grade.
Mm-hmm.
You hit a girl, yo. I got daughters. Couldn't have been me. Because I'd have came up to that school and you wouldn't even have to bring the police. Because after I got done with you, you wouldn't hit another girl again. As men, we are immature when we're younger. All right, let's just go ahead and admit it. We are immature. We don't know what common sense is. We don't know what maturity is, right? But that's when a man needs to step in and pull him aside early and say, yo, that ain't the business. Because you going back and forth with a young lady ain't going to get you nowhere. I don't think men realize this. Women can set you up and you won't be on this earth no more. Because women are powerful when it comes to the mouth.
Mm-hmm.
So if me and you, so let's say me and you were her brothers, right? We're in the seventh grade, and she comes home and say, DJ Andrew, such been messing with me. We ain't thinking nothing. We not finna talk to you. We not thinking of none of that. What we know is right now, we on 100, we see red, and when we see you tomorrow, we gonna handle you. Right?
Just believe.
How many male teachers at the school that you at? That's my first question.
One, two. I'm gonna count myself. Three. Four.
Mm-hmm.
Five.
Mm-hmm.
Six. Admin.
Mm-hmm.
Seven, eight. Nine.
So it's nine men.
About nine or 10.
Okay. So we're going to say 10. So it's 10 men. I'm not talking about you right now. All right. I'm going to take you out of the equation right quick. So it's nine men who worked there. All right. That were there last year. Mm-hmm. And you mean to tell me that nobody knew that this child came from a situation since his fifth grade year? That's what you're telling me. Because he's in the sixth grade now. So which means nobody went and did research on this young man and said, hey, let me reach out to these fifth grade teachers because something's, you know, I can sense something is wrong. So I need to know what happened when he was in your class. How did you fix it? Like, how did you handle him?
Mm-hmm.
But now we got to have a parent-teacher conference. And he just started sixth grade. So that means nine times out of 10, if he was like this in fifth grade, his parents already know. Already know this. This is nothing new. This is a constant thing. This is constant. This is constant. But yet, something wrong with that child, man. Now it's time for you to put your big boy pants on, sir. And you gonna have to reach out to him the best way that you can. I don't care if you got to talk to him before school starts to get his mind mentally prepared, or put him on a plan. And I ain't talking about no behavior plan. What's your goals? Put you on a goal plan. Let's put you on a plan to where, all right, if you do X, Y, Z, then these are the rewards that
you get.
You can get. But you already on the paper trail. I told you when you first met me, I hate paper trails. Remember I told you that? Mm-hmm. That pisses me off because you said it. You like, coach, my man's you on a paper trail. And school ain't even been in that long. So I'm not cool with that. I'm not down for it with any child that's black, brown. I don't care if it's male or female. A paper trail is not what you want. Because that's a quick way to get you out. Because then I ain't got to deal with you. So the more I write you up, the easier it is for me to get you out. And then when I get you out, then what you gonna do? And then I'm gonna make a call to a couple of schools, say, hey, you don't want Ryan to come to your school because he gonna do this, he gonna do that. That young man hurting, bro. This one time you might need to figure out his story. Let me rephrase figure. You might want to know his story, where he come from, what his background is.
I'm gonna have to, because this will be, let's see, when did I start? This will be a week. Well, yeah, this will be a week since I started. Mm-hmm. So since studying that class. So it'll be a week.
I'm challenging you. I'm challenging you on this podcast live in full effect. I'm challenging you to be that male teacher that he needs. I'm challenging you. I'm calling you out.
Okay.
Because at the end of the day, I know you can do it. That's why I'm calling you out. I'm not calling you out because I'm angry. I'm calling you out because what have you always said to me, Coach? I come to you. I need you to lift me up. I need you to help me. I need you to guide me. This is me guiding you and lifting you up. You have to take responsibility for this young man. Because we're in a profession where people do not care no more.
Right.
They don't care.
Right. They don't. You know?
See, everybody wants to teach first grade, second grade. Everybody wants to teach kindergarten, right? You don't even get that many problems in fifth grade, right? Don't nobody want to teach middle school students through high school. Why?
Because they ain't problems. I don't want to deal with problems.
Exactly.
They too much. They difficult.
Mm-hmm. Disrespectful. They don't listen to me. They don't do this. They don't have you ever sat down and asked yourself, well, what is it that I'm doing? Have you ever asked yourself, well, how can I relate to my children and still get them to learn? Has anybody ever just asked that question? We'll wait.
You know how many times I said that today? I'll wait.
And here's the thing. They're not bad. All right, let's stop using that phrase. We use that phrase somewhere. They're just bad. Everybody's not bad. You just don't know what people are going through. We don't know what these kids go through on a daily basis, man. We don't know. Look. Let's get personal with people. We don't know these children are going through abuse at home. We don't know what mommy doing. We don't know what daddy doing. You understand what I'm saying? We don't know if grandma be tearing they behind up abusively. We don't know. We don't know if they're going from house to house.
Right.
We don't know this. We only see what's on the outside because we can't really see what's on the inside. So we fake the funk. We keep the mask on because we know if we keep the mask on, we can hide it. But once we take the mask off, everything's revealed now. Nobody think about that? I'm on a teacher panel, y'all. I seen the questions that they're going to ask. I'm going in because this is the stuff that needs to be talked about. You know, the same thing, you know, the questions that I always ask, bro, what is most exciting about being an educator, right? Do you enjoy teaching and why? You know, what do you do to ensure your classroom climate is inviting? Like, we can all answer those questions. Right. Hey, I do this. I play music. You know what I'm saying? I do this. I do. But then when you get to them tough questions, you know, how do you handle a child that's ESE? You know, how do you handle a child that comes from an abusive home? Like, when them questions get done, everybody, you know, you got people on the panel like this.
Put their hair down. I don't want to answer that question.
I don't want to answer that. But guess what? You're going to answer today because you're an educator. So how do you handle it? What you're doing, Andrew, is great. You're going through the fire. That's fine. You're supposed to. This is what you want to be. You want to be a teacher. You want to be an educator. You want to give back to the community and make sure that our children get what they need to get, so that whether they go to college, whether they go to trade school, beauty salon, we don't care. We just want to instill in you what you need so you can be successful. oh, bro, I done got, listen, and while I'm out, well, I done got bashed, boy. Oh, you just ran away from education. You just went the easy route. No. Coaching not easy. Because when you recruit somebody, you don't know what type of background they come from.
You don't know what story they come from.
Exactly. Yeah, I might not be doing no lesson plans. But coaching ain't easy. I might have to go to the hood 1 week to recruit a child. I'm knowing their story. And the gang member's like, all right, coach, you get a pass. Only because, you know what I'm saying, you're going to such and such house and we really want to see them up out of here. But if I wasn't no coach, you think they'd be letting me come through that?
Mm-hmm.
Even as a teacher. Yo, what you doing here? Oh, nah, they ain't going to school no more. So, yo, we giving you like 45 seconds to get up out of here. Because if you don't, it's going to be some issues. Look, I ain't Superman. All right, fine. You got it. I'll see them tomorrow. Nah, you ain't going to see them tomorrow.
Okay.
Ain't got nothing to do, right? But I'm trying.
Right.
But if this is where his behavior is coming from, what I'm going to do?
Not do anything? I can let him act the way he is?
But I can't control what happens from the environment that you come from. I can't put my life on the line because of the environment that you come from. And that's probably why you acting out, because you're like, I want to get out. Like, help me. I want to get out. I want to get out. That's just what it is. He's screaming for help, yo. Does he come from a single parent home? Is the dad there? Like, it's a lot of stuff you got to ask yourself. Like, yo, like, what type of background he got? Because if dad's not at the crib, if dad's not in the life, you already know how that play out. Mm-hmm. It's already tough on men as it is, but now you add a deadbeat. And then tell me what a deadbeat is, because sometimes it don't even be the dad's fault. The mom just don't want you to see the child. Like, what you supposed to do? And there are men out there that will fight to see their children, but at the end of the day, mouth of a woman gets them anything that they want. And I can be working, I can be providing, but you can go in front of the judge and say he ain't doing none of that. But then when I bring out them receipts, that's why men need to start realizing, always have your paperwork ready. All right, so look, Lil Ryan was doing XYZ, right, in your class. But in my class, this is all the positive paperwork. And you see the negative paperwork ain't as stacked as the positive. So what you doing? If you're going to paper trail him, bro, paper trail him on the positive that he do. Don't paper trail him on that negativity stuff, bro. Or put in a behavioral system for him where don't nobody got to know it's for him, bro. You ain't even got to put it out there like that. But you going to have to talk to this young man. Now talk to him. Don't scold him. Don't embarrass him. He already doing enough embarrassment as it is.
I'm going to talk to him tomorrow morning and see before class starts. Like, hey, listen. I don't know you.
Right.
Okay. I've been here since Friday. I don't know you. I don't know where you come from. I don't know your story. I don't know. I can tell you my story. Right. If you want me to.
Right. Right. Got it. You're gonna have to go deep, bro. That's just facts, son. You're gonna have to go deep, yo. Man, it's crazy. It's really crazy, yo. Like, education, it's not the same. But that don't mean it can't go back to what it used to be. That don't mean it can't go back how it used to be. Because every child isn't a behavior issue.
Mm-hmm.
Just certain people. And I keep trying to say this. Nobody wants to listen. Nobody never wants to listen to what we have to say.
No.
His can feel your vibe. And if you negative and they know you don't care for them, they're gonna treat you like you won't treat them.
They're gonna treat you negative. They don't care. That's why they don't want to come to your class every morning. They don't care.
They don't.
Like, oh, why I gotta go to his class for? He boring. He strict.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And you might not even be boring. Yeah, you understand what I'm saying? But at the end of the day, like, nobody can be me. And I don't want nobody to be me. But it just used to be funny because they'd be like, well, but Aaron, Coach, Lord, how you get the kids to like you? So I'm just me. See, first thing, my kid, oh, Coach Taddy, yeah, I am. But I get off of your behind, though, so let's go ahead and get this straight right now. Mm-hmm. I run this classroom. This is my domain. These are your limits. This is what I expect from you. And we're going to have a great year. And guess what? I ain't worried about no more. Because guess what them kids know? Oh, your coach like that. He cool. You know what I'm saying? He let us do what we do. But at the end of the day, we're going to respect them lines, them boundaries with him. See, I don't know what you do over in English. But when you get over here in history,
it's a different ball. We're going to shut it down.
But then what do I supposed to do? As a teacher, I'm supposed to go over there to the English class and say, yo, look, I don't know what you're doing over here. But when they come to my class, I do X, Y, Z. Find something that they like. They have to come to your class because if they don't pass your class, they don't get the credit for it. So you got to implement English into a way that they understand it and that they'll make class fun and they can get their mind off the, oh, Lord, I got to go to this class again. Or I'm going to act up today. I want to get kicked out because I want to go to Coach Fred class today. Nah, we ain't going to be doing that either. I done had that happen to me. I just want to go to Coach class. Can you kick me out? Oh, no, sir.
No, sir.
You're going to take your behind back to class. Coach, man, why you doing me? Bro, you're going to take your behind back to class. I ain't going to tell you again. And guess what? Yes, sir. That's because I earned respect from the kids. It's okay to earn respect from children, yo. If you want respect, give it. I don't know why these teachers be feeling like, if they don't respect me, it's my classroom. Okay, I get that. I know your name is on front of the door. But at the end of the day, you don't know where they come from. You don't know how they feeling. Just earn the respect. Because if you earn the respect, they'll do anything that you ask them. Now, don't ask them to go blow up no bus or nothing like that. But what I'm saying is, if you tell them to take notes, guess what?
They're going to take notes. If you tell them to, hey, take a quiz, they're going to take a quiz.
Even if they fail, they'll still take it. But they'll let you know, hey, I ain't going to lie, Miss Elroy, I ain't studied for this quiz. Guess what, Ms. Arrow said, look, it's okay. I just wanted to see, let me see where you're at. This is what we're going to do. This is what you need help with. I'm going to wipe this one clean. But these are the things that you need to study for. So throughout the 9 weeks, you start understanding. If you need some extra tutoring, let me know. So then that way, after football practice or basketball practice, or even before you go to work, whatever it is, I can tutor you to get you where you got to get you. And guess what they're going to say? Yes, ma'am. Yes, sir. I'll be there. And they'll be there. Oh, Miss Elroy, I'm going to call out. Because I, you know, hey, boss, look, man, I got a real big test in the morning. My teacher's helping me. Is it okay if I'm not? Sure. I just work a double. You know what I'm saying? Like, I work a double on Saturday. And now when you take that test in Miss Elroy's class, you feel good about it. Because she took that time out because she gave you her respect and now she's gained your respect. And so now she ain't got no problem out of nobody in that class because everybody knows the limits, the boundaries. Well, it's not hard. Stop blaming the school board about everything. I'm going to run to the school board. I'm going to do it. Man, the superintendent got a whole lot of other things to be worried about, some behavioral management that you all should be able to do on your own. It's not hard. Stop telling people behavior management is hard because it's not.
No, it's not.
It's not hard.
If you know the student's background / story, it wouldn't be an issue.
Haven't you been working there for 15 years? There ain't nothing new. That's what kills me with them, Andrew. Dang. You've been working for 15 years. You still going through behavior problems?
Come on. 15 years.
So if you graduated college at 21, 15 years, and you're 36, ain't no way. You done been with these kids since you was goddamn a graduate of college. And you still gonna do problems? Ain't no way between here and hell. You still gonna do problems. 15 years in the game. And please don't give us that. Well, you just don't know what we go through as teachers. Yeah, I was a teacher. I know what we go through, but we don't go through it as dramatic as y'all be making it seem. Well, my kids ain't want to wear their masks today. Okay. Do like I did. Shh. Coach, what you doing? Lights off.
Back up.
You ain't finna give me no germs. And guess what them kids realize? Okay, let me stop playing with Coach. Let me put this mask on. Because every time Coach coming over here with them goddamn Clorox wipes and he wiping his table, like, dude, I'm not spraying no stuff in their face. You understand what I'm saying? But I'm spraying that table. Back up. Get up. Let me spray your seat.
Mm-mm. I move away just like this. Mm-mm. I don't know what you have.
The mask isn't the problem. The mask have never been the problem. But y'all trying to put kids in danger? Oh, if you wear the mask, you that's abuse to a child. See, that's what this stupid behind lady said, bro, on the TikTok today. Well, it wasn't today, but I seen this TikTok, bro. This lady said that's abuse. How? If you don't want your child to wear no mask, keep them home. You teach them.
Homeschool. Do online learning. There you go.
It's no excuse. It's no excuse at all about these masks. It's no excuse about why we can't handle behavior issues. It's no excuse about why we can't handle trauma. There are no excuses. It's too many resources out here, yo. Too many resources out here. I'm not finna go on the internet and tell 15 million people this resource here. No, because y'all know what resources y'all have. Y'all just choose not to use them. And then you wanna say, oh, well, I'm having a mental breakdown.
Okay. All right, well.
A mental breakdown because you don't know how to run your classroom? No, there are teachers out there that really have mental breakdowns. And it's not because they don't have the ownership. They go through some stuff. Mm-hmm. If you're a teacher lead, you can have a mental breakdown because if you don't prepare the team right, that means everybody fails. And when everybody fails, that falls back on you. If you're a principal of a school and that school don't get that grade, that falls back on you. And if you're a dean and your behavior is not where it needs to be, and you suspend more than you keep in, that falls back on you. That's a mental breakdown. That's mental. Because you got to deal with this every day. It's a cycle, right? You go through it every year. So then don't you ask yourself a question? Well, what do I need to work on? Because when you're a principal, don't you run the school? That's your school, right? So who's in your circle that's going to help you make that school than what you want it to be, right? And then as a dean, who are you talking to that's going to uplift you to say, okay, this is how we do behavior plans at my school. See if we can incorporate it, right? With your ideas. And then we go down, right? Team leads, all that, right? So now everybody has a plan in place with their little swagoo. Once they add their little magic to it, we should be rocking and rolling. That's how we stop the mental part, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's how the mental part is stopped, right? And then guess what? There won't be no more. There won't be no emotional breakdowns either because the mental is already fixed. So there's no need for you to be emotionally breaking down in class like this. I'm like, no. Let me go back to my plane. Now, let me emphasize this. If you don't bring your pencil into class, you get a zero for the day. I got my phone. No. What that say right there?
Pencil. No paper. Phones. No phones in my class. No phone. What you doing?
So if you take a picture, you get a zero.
I'm taking an iPhone.
And I know you're not going to give me your phone. So since you're not going to give me your phone, I'm going to just tell you to go to the office. Got to put it in place. Now, if you're that teacher that says, all right, you can bring a pencil, pen, or you have the option of using your phone to take your notes, that's a horse of another color. Right? And then when I go through my 15-minute lecture, you heard me say that correct, 15 minutes. I'm not going to lecture you the whole hour. No, 15 minutes, and then everything else is independent studies. I will allow you to, what's in my ear? Your AirPods. I will allow you to listen to the music while you finish the work in this class. So what behavior problems you going to have now, Mr. Fred? Because I've given the instructions. You know what they expect. Mm-hmm. You're doing your work, AirPods in. What behavior issues we got?
Should be none.
Should be. But you know it's all that one person that's going to try to test you.
Right.
That's fine, too, because I don't have to make a scene. Because then what I'm going to tell you is, everybody put your AirPods up, and you're going to listen to what I listen to. But you still going to get my work done. But we're going to listen to this little Beethoven in here, though, because I know y'all was over there listening to Young Boy and doing your little thing, and I gave you the freedom, but since you got classmates in here who think this is a game.
It's not a game no more. Put on some smooth jazz.
Yeah, we're going to listen to this Beethoven. And if you choose not to do your work, come on up here now so I can go ahead and put that zero in the grade book.
It's not a game. Me.
But guess what? You got that management now because that young lady, that young man should then come to you and say, yo, coach, I apologize, yo. That was on me. And not only did I make myself look bad, but I cost everything for the class too. See, when they can take responsibility of their actions that they've done, that's what an educator does.
I'll be like, well, you need to get it together. Up on the train. Let's go.
But that's an educator.
Everybody else that's working. They got their headphones in. They're working. But you decided to act up. You did this for why? For what?
Exactly.
Get it together.
And guess what you haven't done? You ain't embarrassed that child. You ain't singled them out. And when they walk away from that desk, they're like, all right. All right. They care about me. You know, they ain't calling me out like how I would normally supposed to be. You understand what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. It's not hard, people.
Not hard. Even a sub can...
Even a sub
hasn't been in the education game yet. Haven't set foot in the education game. Knows how to do this.
Mm-hmm.
About to start college in October, and I know this.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I sub.
So.
Wow.
Say what we're going through, what we feel, how we're handling it, and what we can do to become better coaches, educators, podcasts. It don't matter, yo. Everything we're doing from here on out is going to be a learning experience and how to help us grow.
So I nothing. Yeah.
It's enough negativity in life. So if you're going to bring negativity, keep your comments to yourself. That's it. From here on out. Because I'm not going to go back and forth with people who I always got to be negative about something. Because that just lets me know that your life must be that bad. Talk to me.
I'm like, oh, you don't know my story. Okay. You don't know what I've gone through. Okay. Is this a competition to see, oh, mine's worse than yours? Really? Okay. Let's sit down and talk about it. Let's compare and contrast.
Exactly.
Not having a blown-on war trying to figure out who has the biggest problem in the world.
You right, bro. You right. Ain't nothing to say about it. Ain't nothing to say after that.
What? I got cooked speechless. Okay.
Yeah. I mean, because I don't know everything. Right. But at the end of the day, I like to listen to other people. See, that's something people don't know about me. I like to listen to other people. Especially when my energy matches their energy or their energy matches my energy. Man, listen, what more you got to say? But at the end of the day, it's the same thing.
Same thing, but different wording.
Exactly.
And note, we don't get paid to say this.
We don't.
Let's go ahead and get that out of the way. We don't get paid to say this. Okay. Exactly. Like our conversation from the other day. $1,000 just to speak of what we know.
Oh. I got to make you laugh. Remember we was talking about that thing about the speaking? Mm-hmm. The money thing, yeah, bro. Right. I'm finna make you laugh. So the dude said, he like, hey, coach, I like, what's up? You know what I'm saying? Like, mm-hmm. Like what's good? So he was like, I noticed we got a phone call. He was like, hey, is this Darnell? So you know me, I'm like, this is Coach Darnell Jerome. Like, yeah, like my ex, who this is. So mm-hmm. He told me. He's like, you got to call me. I'm like, yo, what's good? Like, good morning. You know, he's like, man, no complaints at all. He was like, I just wanted to be sure you put on your application. I wanted to just be sure because you didn't put on your application that you had a minimum of $97 to invest into your speaking career today. And I'm like, nah. I said, look, man, I've seen the things that you've done. You know what I'm saying? I said, and, you know, I've been speaking, like, just because my name's not out there. So he was like, well, no worries. You know what I'm saying? He was like, here's another free training further that can help you. Then he said, right now, let's table this conversation for a later time when you can make a financial investment in your speaking career. I don't have to put no money on myself. And so because I don't want to pay $97, you want to schedule the conversation another time. Who does? Dude, like, all y'all out here who are motivational speakers, nobody is knocking your hustle. All right, but y'all are quick to say you make this much, you make that much, this is what you get. And why can't y'all just do things from y'all heart, yo? If somebody is interested, if you put on your Instagram post, yo, I'm doing a free training, or hey, if you want to learn how to get into this business, I'm offering free help and advice. Why are we asking for money?
It better be free. Now, no free trial, free.
You said free. You said free on your Instagram. I seen it. I recorded it. So you can't go back and say you didn't. See free. How I talk first.
$0.
Listen to me how I talk. And then if it's something that you feel you can invest in, you say, all right, but look, you do XYZ, just tweak this a little bit. I'm gonna help you get your first gig, and you ain't gotta pay me nothing. Why we can't do that? Why everything gotta have a price?
Right. We speaking from my heart, like, really?
But I got to give you $97, and because I don't want to give you $97, I'm not interested in speaking. Man, look, bro, I'm a basketball coach. I'm a college coach on top of that. All I got to do is reach out to an AD. Hey, my name is Coach Darnell Jerome, Salem University Women's Assistant Basketball Coach. I would love to come and talk to your girls' basketball program. Okay, coach.
I can do that, too.
How much you charging? Not charging anything.
Anything. No, I can do that,
but too. Guess what they school to say? Nah, we want to put some in his pocket. Well, coach, we want to just give you a check for $200. All right.
That's fine.
But understand this, I'm doing it because I know there's things that needs to be said when it comes to women basketball. And let our women know that they're still queens. They need to stop being disrespected. They need to stop being discriminated upon because they play ball. Or they do this, they do that. Doesn't matter. Because everybody says it's a man's world. in some aspects it is. But not at all. Because in education, it darn sure ain't a man's world. It's a woman's world.
Mm-hmm.
Women run the education industry. Women run the nursing industry. Let's just be real.
Or cooking.
That's a mixture. I think that's 50-50. Cooking, I think it's 50-50. I think, I ain't saying, but you know, but there's some women that are starting to, you could be right down the road. It might be taking a problem. But still, at the end of the day, everything is not a man's world. And we're supposed to be leaders, right? Mm-hmm. But how can we lead when we still got childish ways? Don't no woman want to follow no man that's going to lead them to danger? You're supposed to protect them, right? Mm-hmm. Same thing with school, bro. As a male educator, you're supposed to protect your children,
right,
from any hurt, harm, or danger. That's what make a man attractive to a woman, when they can handle their business and when they know what's important and when they can put their selfishness to the side. So if you ever want to talk to me and Andrew about dating, yo, we can go there too, because boy, we gonna go from future educators talk to dating experts in a minute, because at the end of the day, it just seems like it just, because bro, if you think about it, a man don't want to be with a woman if she make too much money, and then a woman don't want to be a man because I'm independent and
Really?
And I don't want to date you because you a teacher and I'm the AP. Does it matter? Does it matter? Because at the end of the day, we're still making an income together. Only difference is you making more than me. Okay. And I ain't even tripping about that.
You want to leave because I make right. less than you? Really? Oh, I don't want to be with him. He's an 8th grade math teacher and I'm an AP. So I'm going to leave him.
Are we okay, in a if you... Depending on
the problems that we have.
Okay.
Love watching the educators? Well, you can be part of our conversation too. The educators is active on social media. Like us on Facebook and join the conversation by telling us what you think. Also, follow us on Instagram for behind the scenes content. And also follow us on Twitter to stay up to date of what's happening on our show, because you keep the conversation going. So let's get social. So like, comment, and connect with us on the educators.
So if you look at it, right, if you put the two incomes together, it depends on where you at. All right, so let's say Houston, Texas, right? Because I know what they make down there. Houston, Texas is gonna start. I love Houston. Houston Texas is gonna start at about $59,000. This depends. But let's just say you make it $65,000 as an 8th grade teacher. And she's making $85,000.
Wow. $4,000 difference.
You're bringing home $150,000. That's six figures. You're still bringing home six figures together as one. But you don't want to be with me. Made no sense. So you basically saying if you go with another principal that's making 85,000 plus 85,000, that's 170,000. All right, 20,000. But who gonna lead who? Cause both of y'all gonna be stressed. You're gonna have a long day at work. Who gonna cater to who? See me. If I was that eighth grade teacher, this is just me, not this is me. If I know my lady has had a long day, see, I know it's time you get off. I'm gonna run to the store. You know, you get that nice bubble bath. You know what I'm talking about, bro. You get that nice bubble bath, soothe it, put the rose petals on there. You know what I'm saying? Put the candles around, you know, and you write that little note, and then you make a trail. Because she's had a long day. Mm-hmm. She don't want to think about no education. When mm-hmm. she gets home.
You want to relax. She want to chill.
But she don't know that you did this. So when she gets home, she like, okay. So she walking out. She like, then she get out. Then she come out. Dinner's cooked?
What?
Okay. Right? It's the small things. Women always say that. It's the small things that count.
Right.
People might say that's big. Might be big in your eyes, but it's smaller her because you took time out of your long day to make sure that she gets what she needs.
She gets
it. That room. Yeah. You took care of her mentally, emotionally, and spiritually. You took care of her. So now when she gets out, she happy. Now when she goes to work in the morning, she's happy.
She excited. She ain't got to worry about no problems. She happy. Next you know, she gossip about to her co-workers about her.
If you just want to be petty, and I don't mean petty in a bad way, but then say she call you. Look, they're getting on my nerves, you know, this testing, you know, I know we got it, it's just stressful. And you say, baby, go in your office. And she look, why is there a teddy bear sit? Small things. Because I knew you were stressing. And so I got this teddy bear for you, Joe, just in case you ever, you can just hug it real tight. And just let all your aggression out, right? But it's the small things.
Yeah.
If you're trying to figure out how you got in my office, don't worry about all that.
Don't worry about it.
Just know.
Just magic. That's why
when you go through something, you think of me. You think of them kids. Them kids need you. Being a man is not hard. Just know what you want. And how you want it. And when you know that, you won't be just another dude, if that makes sense. That's the clean version. Because I always hear that. Oh, y'all just the same. Who?
Who?
They ain't come out my mama. I don't know what you. Because men get hurt too. So we can say that about y'all. All women are gold diggers.
They'll be like, who? Oh, okay.
Right.
Right, okay. But
no, at the end of the day, these are just some life lessons that needs to be talked about. Chivalry is not dead, women. If you carry yourself like the queen you are, you'll get the king you deserve.
Ooh.
And men, if you carry yourself like the king that you are, you'll get the queen that you deserve. And you won't begin these princesses or these princes. You'll get your whole kingdom out here. Because if you ever played spades, spades are the deadliest in the game because it cuts everything.
Mm-hmm.
Get you a queen of spades, you'll get you a king of spades. And when you join it together, you're a dynamic force.
The dynamic duo. Can't stop us. Just like
all right. Yeah. On that note, bro, we ain't finna get no more advice, bro. On that note, I feel like we done covered everything that we needed to, and then do some other stuff in there too. Like,
hey, I told you. Research in our brains. No more topics. No more anything. Know what we need to know. That's it.
That's it. That's it.
All right. Well, thank you all for listening or watching this episode. Stay tuned next week.
Next week?
For another brand new episode.